Buongiorno tutti! Welcome to Calabria Dreaming! My name is Lily. I'm coming to you live from Calabria. And I am so excited to make this video. I've had so many emails come in. Ever since I launched my website, I cannot respond quick enough. I've gotten so many emails and comments and people wanting to know, how can I move to Italy? How can I get residency? So today's video is actually dedicated to my subscribers and viewers and audience in India. I got so many emails from people in India that want to know how they can move here to Italy. So I'm gonna go over all the ways that you can get residency and then eventually how you can get citizenship and how you can move to Calabria. So the first way I'm gonna talk about is the way I was able to get residency here, and that is by falling in love. It's very easy to fall in love here in Italy. And ladies, let me tell you something, the Italian men, next level, super romantic, super handsome, super just amazing. I'm sorry, American and Canadian guys, you guys need to go to like romance university, okay? And that's Italy. You come here how to romance. It's very easy to fall in love. I ended up falling in love with my husband at a disco on my birthday in Florence. Super random. Fell in love. It was love at first sight pretty much. And then 6 months later, I had a little Italiano in the oven and I was able to get residency while I was pregnant. I got a permesso di soggiorno for 5 years. So you do have to like provide documents that you're pregnant and that the father or the mother is Italian, and then that way they will grant you residency. So I got that for 5 years, and my 5-year permesso di soggiorno is coming to an end, and I'm going to apply for citizenship. So if you're a mother of an Italian and you, I think it's 2 years or 3 years you've lived in Italy, you can apply for citizenship. In order to get citizenship, you do have to pass a language exam, and it is intermediate, so you do have to be pretty well spoken in Italian, and then there's a couple other tests that you have to take, and then you can get citizenship. So I'm definitely going to do that. I am not searching for any other place to live. I was searching for a long time. I wasn't happy living in the United States for many years, and I traveled around the world thinking, could I live here? Can I live here? Can I live here? Could I live here? And then when I came to Calabria especially, I was like, ah, I found it. So I'm not going to be searching anymore to move or anything like that. So I'm going to get my Italian citizenship and just live out my glorious life here for the rest of my life. And I'm very happy about that. So that's the easiest way, in my opinion. Come to Italy and fall in love. Hello, that's not hard at all. So come to Italy, fall in love, get married, or have a baby. Easy, right? The second way you can come and get residency here is through ancestry. So there's something called here, what is it called? Right of blood. So sangue italiano. If you have an Italian grandma or grandpa and you can prove that they were born in Italy somehow, or they immigrated from Italy, you can actually get your residency and then later your citizenship. You do want to handle all of that paperwork in your home country. So when you're already there, you can go to the embassy and talk to them and show them all that documentation. And it's pretty straightforward. A lot of people go that route. A lot of people are Italian. No, not only. A lot of people are Calabrian. Calabrians are all over the world. A lot in New York, a lot in Toronto. My gosh, Canada, there's so many Calabrians. A lot. Calabrians get around, okay? So we're very popular in the world. So if you have, if you think you might have an Italian grandma or grandpa, it's worth looking into. Once you get that documentation, you can show the embassy that, and then you can get your citizenship eventually. All right, and then let's get into the visa. So there's several different types of visas that you can get in order to get permanent residency here, permesso di soggiorno, in Italy. The first one is a student visa. So a student visa, you have to apply for it within 8 days of arriving into Italy, and it's pretty straightforward. You go to the poste, which is like our Italian post office, but a lot of like bureaucratic stuff happens there. So you go there, you get this application, you fill it out, you pay a fee, then you go to the police station, you get fingerprinted, all this crazy stuff. You do have to obviously prove that you're going to school here. But there's a lot of schools here, you guys. There's cooking schools, there's farming schools, there's art schools, there's language schools. I mean, you can definitely find a school and enroll and then have them write you a letter and then use that to get a student visa. So that's definitely a route that you can take. The second way, or the fourth way you can go, is through an elective residency visa. So this is one of the most restrictive visas. So it doesn't allow you a lot of freedoms, and it's very bureaucratic and it takes some time. And what you need to do is you need to prove 31,000 euros per year of passive income. So if you're retired, or if you're getting alimony or something like that, if you just have passive income coming in, you can come to Italy and get an elective residency visa. The only thing with this visa that I don't really like so much is that you are not allowed to work here. So you're not allowed to start any businesses or find jobs here. So it's just like for people who are retirees or people who have just independent income coming in, okay? The fifth way that you can come in is called the golden visa or the investor visa. So if you're sitting on a pile of cash and you don't know what to do with your life, come to Italy, come to Calabria and invest money. So the first level is 250,000 euros. You can invest that money into an Italian startup, or 500,000 euros. And then there's the 1 million euro charity level. And that one has a lot of freedoms. It's less bureaucratic. Obviously, if you're gonna come here and invest $1 million, the Italian government wants you to be here, especially Calabria. Calabria is a great place to invest if you are a big dreamer, big thinker. Calabrians don't know what they have themselves here in Calabria. They don't see what somebody like I see when I come here. I just see so much potential, zero competition, and the time to do it. So if you have a lot of money, you have a lot of cheddar, you have a lot of moolah, come to Italy, come to Calabria, invest it here, and then live here for the rest of your life. Pretty simple, right? $1 million. And then there is the third visa, which is my favorite visa. It's called the business visa. So this one is definitely very bureaucratic. It takes some time. And this one, you need to prove that you have 10,000 euros per year to get started here in Italy, and that you're gonna invest in some sort of business. So you can buy a house that way, considered a business. You can come and open a school. If you have 10,000 euros and you wanna come to Italy, getting a business visa is the best way, okay? You can work with that visa, you can start businesses, so that's why I like it the most. I mean, obviously, if you have 1 million euros or 250,000 euros, come to Italy, that's easy. But if you don't have all that money and you wanna work, a business visa is the way to go. And then the next way to get residency is by buying a house. However, I was not able to confirm that this is like a sure shot way of getting residency. I've spoken to a lot of people that have moved here who got their residency that way, but I wasn't able to confirm it on any like government websites. So you would have to check with your embassy first. You know, obviously always check every piece of information that you're getting before you come here. But I believe if you come here and you buy a 100,000 euro house, a lot of people have gone to the comuna and said, look, I have a house here, I want residency. And a lot of people, everybody I've spoken to had gotten their residency that way, but I just wasn't able to confirm it. So business visa is probably the best way to go. Student visa is a great way to go. And falling in love and having a baby is also a great way to go. So let me know if any of you guys are really thinking about moving out to Italy, and specifically to Calabria. Calabria really is such a fertile land. There's so much you could do out here. There's farming, there's schools, there's like hotels. There's no big chain hotels here. And not that I want that here, but there is a lot of possibility for tourism. You just have to be a real self-starter. Calabria is not like gonna give you anything on a silver platter. You have to really work for what you want here. But with that risk and with that work comes a huge reward, and that reward is living in literally the most beautiful place I've ever seen in my life. So I hope you guys got a lot out of this video. Let me know if you're thinking about moving to Calabria in the comments below, or you can always email me and let me know what you guys think. And I also just wanna say thank you guys so much for liking and subscribing to my videos. I am so thrilled to have 1,000, I can't even believe it, 1,000 subscribers. I just never imagined this would happen. I literally started this channel just because I was doing lockdown, having like in a bad, funky area, and I needed to focus on something positive. So I started making these videos about how beautiful it was here. And here we are, you know, 1,000 subscribers later, and people really interested about Calabria, really want to know more and want to find out how they can move here. And it makes me so happy and thrilled. I'm thrilled. So thank you guys, all those people who emailed me in the last 2 weeks. I hope this answered your questions. I hope you guys guys have a lovely day, and I can't wait to see you here in Bella Calabria. So we'll see you soon. Ciao.